Greetings to all. This is Architect Thilakavathi, Assistant Professor, Crescent School of Architecture. I am here to share a few thoughts about the subject Theory of Architecture, which is supposed to be the basic core subject of B.Arch degree program. Why do you need to know Theory of Architecture? This is something that we have been doing from the school. When we started to study languages in school, first what will we be doing? We will be studying the alphabets of that language. So how we use the alphabets in that particular language and how do we practice that alphabets? The more we practice, the more proficient we become in that particular language. Likewise, if architecture is considered to be the language of architects, then we need to know about the theory of architecture, that is the basic elements and principles that are used in the architecture field. So the more we use and practice the elements and principles of architecture, the more proficient we would become in the field of architecture. So this part is something to do with the three basic phases. That is, first thing, definition of architecture, origin of architecture, architecture as a discipline. So what is the discipline and definition of architecture? What is architecture? The most preliminary introduction to what is architecture, it was actually originated from the Greek word architecton. Archi means great, tecton means builder. So architecture is defined as the art and science of designing buildings and structure. A wider definition would also include within the scope of design of any built environment, structure or object, from town planning, urban design and landscape architecture to furniture and objects. If we have to study what is architecture and how it is being defined, in various stages of your career you will be defining what is architecture as you prefer. While you are in your first year of architecture, your understanding and definition of architecture might be different, whereas through your course of career you will define architecture invariably different. So I would like to project a certain definition that is thrown out by masters of architecture. The most ancient definition of architecture is: architecture can be defined as durability, utility and beauty at the right time at the right cost. This is actually put down by Marcus Vitruvius Pollio, who is actually supposed to be the ancient architect of the Roman times. But whereas, if you actually see what Le Corbusier, who is supposed to be the father of modern architecture, has stated, is that architecture is a masterly, correct and magnificent play of masses brought together in light. Both are very different, but at the same time both are very correct actually. So according to the student's perspective, they have to define and understand architecture. But the most preliminary definition of architecture is, it is supposed to be the art and design of spaces. Origin of architecture. The origin of architecture relies on many disputed factors. That is, when and why man became, from his nomadic lifestyle to a permanent structure lifestyle, and when he actually became a community, when he became an intelligent creature to come together to build buildings. These are some of the questions actually give you a theoretical timeline on the origin of architecture. There was a golden age in which there was no disputes between the human beings. So they were actually in the nomadic lifestyle. They did not have any proclaim towards a territory or a region. But when it all started to come to a more patriotic society in which there were a lot of clashes between the human beings, the territorial markings of the regions became very important, and that's where the community started to play into picture, and that's when the human beings started to have their own places, and it actually gradually led to the permanent dwellings. So origin of architecture is directly involved to the modified human needs in terms of shelter, in terms of security, in terms of ways of workshop and so on. So there is a lot of parameters in place that actually gives you the origin of architecture. But it all started off with the hut, and now we can see so many skyscrapers, IT buildings. There are the scope of architecture has raised to many fold in this new millennium. So what is architecture as a discipline? We don't know when and where architecture has started as a discipline, but we do know that the earliest architects were definitely not specialists, but someone who could erect basic dwellings using simple tools and materials found adjacent to the site. Today, architects are licensed by a jurisdiction to provide design services to the public through the practice of architecture, and there are many architecture companies in the field right now. So these are all the basic fields that are actually directly related to architecture in terms of interior design, art, furniture design, etc. But there are so many aspects and fields of other interdisciplinary aspects that are directly connected to architecture. It is a slight overlook on those terminologies. With this, I would like to close this session. Thank you.